Welcome dear students, today we are going to talk about a very important industrial process which is used to convert the pig iron into steel. We have already discussed the working of the blast furnace in detail, and blast furnace is used to manufacture pig iron, and now that pig iron is converted to steel by using a special type of a furnace that is called as the open hearth furnace. My dear students, hearth means the floor of a fireplace, or you can say floor of a furnace. And hearth is the place where charge of the furnace is loaded. Open hearth furnace, OHF, it refers to a furnace which has a wide saucer shaped hearth with a low roof. This open hearth furnace is used to remove the impurities like carbon and other impurities, phosphorus and sulfur from the pig iron, and that pig iron is then converted to steel. It was very difficult to manufacture steel because of its high melting point, so that's why this special type of the furnace was prepared to convert the pig iron into steel. My dear students, in some of the outdated books, it is written that open hearth process is the most modern method of the steel manufacturing. But actually, most of the open hearth furnaces were closed in 1990s, and they were replaced by basic oxygen furnace and electric arc furnace because of the reason that the open hearth process is a very slow process. So the open hearth furnace was introduced by British engineers in almost 1865, and then the open hearth furnaces, they were working till 1990s, but in 1990s, because of the slowness of the open hearth process, most of the open hearth furnaces were replaced by the basic oxygen furnace and electric arc furnace. Now the open hearth furnace works on regenerative principle of heat economy. What is meant by the regenerative principle of heat economy? My dear students, the roof of the open hearth furnace is very low, and this furnace is made up of some special type of the bricks, and those bricks, they absorb most of the heat, almost 80 to 85% of the heat from the hot waste gases, and that heat absorbed is then returned to the fresh air and relatively cooler gases which are introduced into this furnace. In this way, the fuel consumption is reduced and the temperature of the furnace is maintained, and as the fuel consumption will be reduced, the process will become economical. So that is the regenerative principle of the heat economy. There are some regenerators which are used in the furnace which absorb heat, and then they return that heat to the incoming cooler air or the relatively cooler gases. The open hearth furnace, the hearth of this open hearth furnace, that is lined with silica, and when the hearth is lined with silica, just like in black here I have shown that the hearth is having some lining, when the hearth is lined with silica, that is called as acidic lining, and this acidic lining is used to remove the impurities like manganese and silicon. And if the hearth is lined with dolomite, which is a mixture of calcium oxide and magnesium oxide, then this lining is called as basic lining, and this basic lining is used to remove the impurities like phosphorus and sulfur. Now my dear students, the open hearth process is a batch process. Batch process means that the products are made as specified groups or amounts within a specific framework of the time. This is the schematic diagram of the open hearth furnace in front of you. This one is the inlet for some burning gases or the hot gases, as the furnace is heated by the hot gases. The air is introduced, and the oxygen present in this air, that is used to oxidize the impurities like carbon, silicon and manganese. This is the hearth of this furnace where the charge is loaded. The charge is of two types, the lighter charge and the heavier charge. We will discuss that after short duration of time. Then my dear students, this complete portion of the furnace has blast of the air and the hot gases, And the construction of the furnace is in such a way that the bricks, they absorb 80 to 85% heat from the hot waste gases, and they return that heat to the incoming air so that the high temperature inside the furnace is maintained without consumption of the fuel. Now, my dear students, let us discuss what is the open hearth process. This process takes almost 10 hours. And my dear students, first of all, the open hearth furnace is inspected for any damage. Once the inspection is done, then my dear students, the light charge, like the, you can say, scrap or some shredded vehicles, they are placed in the hearth of the furnace, and the hot burning gases are introduced to melt that light charge. Once the light charge is melted, then my dear students, the heavier charge, means the pig iron which is obtained from the blast furnace, that is introduced into the melted light charge or the molten light charge. And once that pig iron is introduced, then the chemical reaction starts. At 1600 degrees C, the atmospheric oxygen present in the air, that oxidizes the impurities. The carbon is changed to carbon monoxide, which is wasted in the flue gases. Silicon gets oxidized to silica, and manganese is oxidized to manganese oxide. In this way, the carbon, silicon and manganese impurities are oxidized to their respective oxides. Now, my dear students, the charge in the open hearth furnace also contains the quicklime, or you can say calcium oxide. This quicklime or calcium oxide is the slag forming agent. So once the silica is formed by the oxidation of the silicon, then my dear students, and manganese oxide is also produced. This silica reacts with the calcium oxide, which is a slag forming agent, and it is converted to calcium silicate. Silica reacts with manganese oxide, manganese silicate is produced. And similarly, the silica reacts with iron oxide, which is present in the pig iron, that is converted to iron silicate. Now, all these three silicates, they form the slag. Slag means the semi-solid waste, and that slag starts floating on the surface of the charge, and then it is removed from that furnace. Now, my dear students, the iron, now it gets reduced. As the oxidation state of iron here, that is +2, and it is reduced to pure iron. And during that reduction process, the sulfur is oxidized to SO2 and phosphorus is oxidized to P2O5. So the sulfur impurities, they are removed in the form of SO2, and the phosphorus impurities are removed in the form of P2O5. And during these reactions, the iron is reduced to the metallic form. And now this iron, that will be present in the molten state here. My dear students, the P2O5 reacts with the slag forming agent, and calcium phosphate is produced. Now, this is an advantage of the open hearth process, that calcium phosphate is produced, and this calcium phosphate acts as an important fertilizer. So the waste of this open hearth furnace, that is calcium phosphate, can act as an important fertilizer. Similarly, the SO2, it reacts with calcium oxide, it forms calcium sulfide. So all these calcium silicate, manganese silicate, iron silicate, calcium phosphate and calcium sulfide, they are present in the slag and they are removed. The carbon impurities are removed in the form of carbon monoxide, and thus you will get the iron now. There is an advantage of this open hearth process, although it is a very slow process, but it is under control. You can take the samples of the steel product after regular intervals, and you will check the carbon content of that steel. When the carbon content of 0.1% is obtained, then you will add the ferromanganese, the calculated quantity of the ferromanganese in that steel. The manganese, that will desulfurize, mean it will further remove the sulfur impurities from the steel, and the carbon is introduced to maintain the required carbon content in the steel, as there are different types of the steel depending upon the percentage of the carbon. So one of the advantages of this process is that you can control this process. You can easily qualitatively check the samples of the steel obtained from this open hearth furnace, and you can introduce the ferromanganese to get the required percentage of the carbon in the steel. So this is one of the advantages of this open hearth process. Now, my dear students, although this process that is very important, but once it was important, now this process is replaced by the basic oxygen furnace and electric arc furnace. And similarly, my dear students, there was a Bessemer process that was once used, and this open hearth process is much slower as compared to the Bessemer process. And the last point is that when the steel is obtained in the molten form, then that steel is placed in the molds, and that molds, then the steel is converted to the ingots. There is a term used in the books, that is ingots. Ingots mean the oblong blocks of the steel. There will be oblong blocks of the steel. They are called as the ingots. And when the molten steel is changed to the ingots, this process is called as taming process. So the conversion of molten steel into ingots, when it is poured into the molds, then that is called as the taming process. So in this way, you can get the steel. And a very important point, again, keep this thing in your mind, that during this process, no doubt it is a slow process, but the percentage of carbon is under your control, and this process can be terminated at any stage where the required percentage of carbon in the steel is obtained. So that was all about the open hearth process. I am very hopeful that this lecture will be understandable for you people. In case you find any problem, you can ask in the comment section. I will definitely answer that. Till then, take care.